is right around the corner, kind of. It's October already. So, I mean, how do we feel about it being October, Halloween? I honestly don't really know how I feel about Halloween. I live in Australia, if you didn't know. Halloween's not really a big thing here. It is on the rise. I see more people every year decorating their houses, people trick-or-treating, people get a bit more serious with their costumes now, but when I was younger, it wasn't really a huge thing, and I just went trick-or-treating. That was the only thing we ever did. I don't know what people my age do now. I think I'm too old to trick-or-treat. I would still do it if it was socially acceptable. Some people might argue that it is. I don't know about that. For me, I think my trick-or-treating days are over, sadly, as fun as it is. But as in terms of Halloween parties, because I feel like it's the next step, you trick-or-treat, then you party, I don't think that's really a big thing here, or at least if it is, I'm not invited to them, so. But I don't think that Halloween parties are really a big thing. But if you are doing something for Halloween and you are in need of a costume, because we all know that costumes is like the most important part of Halloween, as well as the lollies, the candy, the sweets, whatever you call the things with sugar, is what I'm talking about. So this is a serving suggestion. If you're looking for a Halloween costume, happy early Halloween. You have a little bit less than a month to get yourself together. Starting off strong with some costumes, actually, I will be showing some of the ones that I have done myself, as well as ones that I think might be a good idea. So we're going to start off with pumpkin. I know this is probably the most basic idea out there, but it's versatile. You can put in as little or as much effort into this as you wish. This first photo that we have on the right, outside, it's actually me, that is me, with a pumpkin head that I bought from Kmart. It was about $8, $5, I don't know, it was years ago. Very minimal effort, still look put together. The middle picture here, I don't know what this is, but I searched pumpkin costume, and this was like, this kept appearing, and it's so, that's Rosie for you. Rosie's a little pumpkin. So if you want to go and make yourself a shirt, you can wear this all October, all spooky season, and they have a mandarin or an orange in their hand. Anyways, I don't know why I put that in there. Then we have this other wonderful woman who is a pumpkin. I'm assuming you just buy this from somewhere. This is a bit more effort if you're wanting to go out. If you're not thinking originality, but a classic, I think pumpkin is a classic. Pumpkin is like the staple of autumn, fall, Halloween. If you want to be the staple, the moment, the main character, you could go for this pumpkin, and I would go with the woman who is the whole pumpkin, rather than what I did, which was just a head. I wasn't one for putting much effort in these things. It's one night a year. I'm pretty sure the tag is actually still on that. I think I can see the tag on the top of the hat. I still have it. I still have the head. Maybe I'll reveal that at some point. But moving on, I know I accidentally repressed the slide, but Barbie. Okay, maybe we're over this, but you do you. Barbie's probably done a million times every year, but we had the Barbie movie this year, and I think that allows, it kind of gives you a free pass to a slightly less unoriginal idea. But Halloween doesn't have to be about originality, it's about the execution. So I have a range of options here. We have, for all you Kens out there, or anyone that just wants to be Ken, you don't have to be a Ken to dress like Ken. You can be Ken on Halloween. We have the boxed version. This, I don't know if you can breathe. I'm just looking at that now, and I don't know if there's any airflow in there. And it's probably gonna steam up in your face. But that's a you problem, and you can figure that out. And we have this gorgeous girl in the middle, not saying that in a weird way. She is a little mermaid. This, I feel like you kind of just go to the shop and buy and you slip it on, but with these things, your kid can wear it again as a dress up as next Halloween until they grow out of it. So I think that's a simple option. It's not the most effort as well, buying things. And then we had this lovely lady at the end who, I don't know if this is for Halloween. It looks like it could be, she's ready to go to Disneyland completely. But you could go to the maximum effort, you could be the star of the show, and you can look like this woman who is stunning. I would wear that. Moving on to traffic and road safety, I feel like we're getting a little bit more out there with an example of a costume I did myself. 2 years ago, I think this was, it must have been. It's my iconic traffic cone costume that I made by hand. This is the photo in the center. And it was COVID time, so I had the mask, I was protected. I didn't have arms, which was a bit of a thing that I kind of didn't think about, was a bit of an oversight. Road safety, we can go for road safety. This can also be a group costume. We have the traffic light man, we have this group of more traffic cones. You can blend in with the scenery, you can remind people to be road safe, you can protect others with your traffic cone-ness, you can just be a joy to look at. Now moving on to the Smurf. Recently there has been this Smurf cat circulating the internet. I don't know if we're gonna find this funny still by the end of this month. I'm kind of over it, honestly, but I thought, you know, it's a bit of pop culture, we can go for Smurf. I think Smurf is a classic every year. You, again, with the minimal to maximum effort, we have this family, I think they're a family, who've dressed up in costume. And then in the middle, we could also go for, I believe this is Mariah Carey. I didn't do the research, I just searched celebrity Smurf costume and there she was. So you could paint yourself blue, or you could make a paper mache Smurf head like this person on the end, which I think is maximum effort, although they kind of forgot about the rest of the outfit. But I'm not judging what we're wearing, I'm just giving you ideas. So these are ideas. You can buy all of these stuff online if you really wanted to, or you could just paint yourself blue and wear white. Easy. Moving on to the slightly suggestive section, because I think we all know that when we look up Halloween costume, we get some things that are a little bit odd. But if you're one of those people that wants a bit of a laugh from your friends, a bit of a tee-hee-ha-ha, these are for you. These are for you. We have the outlet and socket. I won't explain these too much. We have the one nightstand, the singular nightstand. I'm being really careful with what I say. Then we have this genie who has, you know, that is, and then we have another guy who looks like the same guy in every other photo. I don't know if it is the same guy, but he looks like the same guy, and he has that nice costume. These are quite also minimal effort, but they, I feel like these are original. I've never seen these before in my life. So go ahead, be the goofy, be crazy. If you wanna be a little bit, if you wanna make people feel uncomfortable, wear one of these on Halloween. So there you go, and all you need to do is buy the costume and you can call it a day, and you could wear this any day of the week if you really wanted. Wear it to work for all I care. Now moving on, for all of you people who are twins out there, because I know people who are twins, they just have to do everything together, don't they? You guys have to be together, it's the law. If you're going to dress for Halloween, you must match. And I thought, why would you dress as, like, something that is, you know, peanut butter and jelly? Thing one, thing two. Cat and dog, I don't know. Like, why not dress as another set of twins that we have here? We have the Dolan twins. You could find this exact outfit and you could recreate this exact photo that I found. It was probably the first one I found in Google Images. Then we have, I don't know what these, who these guys are, but they are on TikTok. You've seen them, okay? They have their funny little videos. I don't know their name, but you could dress like them. You just, if you have blonde hair, you could get a blonde wig, put on a white tank, and you could go around and you could like make their kind of videos, you could say the things that they say. And then we also have, this is Steve Harvey, I believe, and his twin daughters. I didn't know that he had twin daughters until I googled like famous celebrity twins. And if you were a trio as well, maybe you have an older or younger sibling and some twins, they could be Steve Harvey, you could be the twins. And I think they're absolutely serving in this photo that we have. You could get their exact outfits. It might be a little bit out there and people may not know who you are. I don't know. But it's unique. And I think people would really appreciate this if you were a set of twins, to be another set of twins and live your twin life. Because you will always be a twin and you can't escape that. You can't escape your siblings. They're your siblings forever. I'd know. I'd have an older brother. I can't escape him. He's not even in the country right now. And I have to message him to use his computer, and I have to see his TikToks that he sends me, and I have to send him one so he knows that I don't not care about him. You know? You can't escape them. Anyways. Wow. Went on a tangent. I think this is Lucky Last. We have groups, because, you know, for the friendly friends with friends, everyone loves to go trick-or-treating to a party, dressing up as a group. It's great. We all love it. We have a few ideas here. We have Total Drama Island. I feel like this has kind of come back in a surge of popularity because of that Roblox game that we all know and love. And there's a lot of character options here. You could have a huge group, a smaller group. You could do a lot of things with this, and they're mostly wearing casual clothes, so I don't think it would be that hard to execute. I don't know. We also have a burger. You could be each piece of a burger. I don't know how on earth they even crafted that, and I'm just seeing now that some of them are wearing heels. This looks like it was taken in New York. I don't want to make assumptions, but this is like totally the thing that you would see in Times Square on Halloween. But I feel like this is very creative. I don't know how you can execute this at home. Maybe you're very creative and crafty, but I don't think you'd be able to execute this kind of thing with this much time left of Halloween. So, but you could kind of be inspired. You could wear colors. I don't know. Maybe next year you can be the burger. Moving on, Modern Family, okay? You could, you know those families that dress as crayons or whatever, Care Bears, every year? Why not just dress as Modern Family, okay? You could do this with your friends as well. You could all wear the white that we have in this photo, kind of. I feel like it is kind of hard to dress just, like, as reality kind of people. This is not a reality show, but they're real people playing human people. They're not like animated. It is a little bit more difficult unless you already look like them, but you could still go for this. There's a wide age range, a variety of looks. You can go for gold. Everyone loves Modern Family. Everyone knows Modern Family. Everyone, we love Modern Family, okay? And last but certainly not least, we have the periodic table, okay? And these kids, I know, are so cool. They look so cool. I love them, not in a weird way. I think they're very creative with their ideas. You could have there's a lot of elements in the periodic table. You could have a huge group. You could just be the one element. You could be whatever you wish, and you could accessorize to your element. You know, we've got the guy with the helium balloons because he's helium. So go for gold. You can have a little less effort with that one. Anyways, that's all I have for you for Halloween. I hope that maybe you found something that could be useful and you enjoyed this video. If you have any other suggestions for a Halloween costume, you could, you know, text me, message me, send it to me in the post. Put it online, put it in the comments, put it up your... I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you have a great Halloween. I hope you find a great costume and you look amazing and everyone loves your costume and you love it too. Have a good rest of your day, evening, and night. Goodbye.